eNCA. Now, if you didn't know, today is the International Day of the Girl Child.
Yeah, well, it's a day every day. The United Nations says the day aims to highlight and address the needs and challenges that girls face.
At the same time, it promotes girls' empowerment and the fulfillment of their human rights.
Well, this year, the theme is With Her, a Skilled Girl Force. And to tell us more, we're joined by Mayke Huijbregts from the UNICEF South Africa to tell us more about
Mayke,
it.
Mayke, good morning and welcome to Morning News Today.
Good morning, it's my pleasure.
The theme suggests that the focus going forward that you want currently society to be really seized with is about skilling our girl children. Am I wrong?
That's correct. Mm. Yeah. So this morning I come to speak to you about four areas. One, we have to start with eliminating violence against girls, so that it is important girls can live without fear and free up their brain space to acquire the right knowledge, the right skills, and to be able to thrive. So the second one is really education. Girls are enrolled in school, primary and secondary, but at times they drop out in secondary due to the adversities girls might face by teenage pregnancies or any kind of HIV infection, STIs, and so on and so on. So it is extremely important that we accompany the girls through this transition from 15 to 24-year-olds, because in South Africa the unemployment rate is highest in that space, and it's especially affecting girls. So it's important to empower the girls with knowledge, with skills, and coach them through tertiary education. Then, with empowerment, it's important that they have opportunity to get internships, apprenticeships, the moment they want to start their own businesses, that they have access to finance.
Mayke, I mean, it's wonderful work, and of course it is the ideal that this would happen, that we would get to do all of those things. But around the world, we're dealing with largely patriarchal societies where girls, and especially girl children, are the targets of many archaic practices. I mean, we're seeing it in India, we're seeing it here in South Africa, we're seeing it throughout Africa as well. How do you get past those cultural barriers? Because those are the girls that you need to reach. Those are the in far-flung areas who are still the victims of practices where they are made to be someone's wife, they are made to be someone's sexual partner. At the age of what, 10, 11, 12, 13, how do you work with that as UNICEF? How do you deal with that?
So around the world, we work with a variety of groups to eliminate child marriage, FGM, to promote girls to stay in schools by working with governments, first of all, line departments on the policies and the laws, but also with religious groups, with the schools, with social media, in order to make sure everyone knows about the right of a girl to education. So it's very important to empower girls themselves too, so that they say no to child marriage and that they stand up for their own rights and that they participate in their own decisions. So it is a layer of interventions that we are working at the same time, in order to make sure that we eliminate violence, empower the girls, and invest in education.
Now, Mayke, what are the numbers telling you? Are you actually succeeding here? Mm. Because every year when we come to this kind of days, we still hear about a large number of girl children who are still having no access to education, or if they do, as you say, they are forced then to drop out for a variety of reasons. What are the numbers telling UNICEF?
So the numbers in South Africa are very shocking, because every 4 minutes a woman or a girl gets raped. One out of three girl children experience a form of violence before the age of 18. And violence and abuse have a negative impact on their development for the rest of their lives. So it is very important that everyone respect a girl to be free from fear in order to be able to learn and to thrive. So we are not thriving yet. It is very important that this is concerted action with a capital investment to boys, both boys and girls from early age, to build a gender equal society with equal rights for both boys and girls and empowerment with skills from the onset.
Now, that's the one challenge that you deal with, is dealing at grassroots and what happens. But let's just say a girl makes it. You know, she gets to school, she gets a qualification, she gets to the workplace. Still challenges there on that level, and that's a different layer of challenges. And also, you know, trying to break those non-traditional or those traditional workplace functions of women, that they're not in certain areas and they only function in certain other places and you know, traditionally doing what was termed women's work?
No, there are challenges there too. Mm. And it's very important to create a workspace free of harassment and create opportunities and equal pay. Mm. Mm. And in a harmonized work environment where both women and men can equally thrive and get equal pay for the work they do, and that women get access to microfinance and opportunities to grow their own businesses and to move forward. And it is true that there are patriarchal systems that at times are hampering an equal opportunity for women in the workforce. And this has to be addressed by every employer to create a work-free environment from harassment and create opportunities equally for all.
Yeah. And Mayke, before you go, very briefly, it is International Day of the Girl Child. In terms of skills and stuff, when you say let's skill up the girl, what is it with her, a skilled girl force? Is it skills across the spectrum, not certain skills?
So it is important that girls acquire knowledge, but also that they learn about problem solving, about teamwork, that they learn to think critically, that they are part of the 21st century with access to ICT and innovative solutions and are able to have access to education, tertiary education, but also vocational skills. And that there is a bridge made by coaching them through internships and apprenticeships to the workforce, so that they don't start working without the proper education and skills. And that's what we see in South Africa a lot, that a lot of girls after secondary start working, but we need an educated workforce in order to move to higher ambitions.
Yeah, no, thank you very much. That's Mayke Huijbregts from UNICEF South Africa. Right.